My whole life, the expression of your grace. Daily as I live, often as I break, let my whole life be expression of your grace. I cry, Abba Father, hallowed be your name. Hallowed be your name. Hallowed be your name. I cry, Abba Father, hallowed be your name. Hallowed be your name. Hallowed be your name. Father, Lord, I thank you and give you glory. Holy Spirit, over to you. I decrease for you to totally increase. Have your way. Speak what you want your children to hear. Help us, Lord. Open our spiritual eyes and ears to be able to understand what you want us to speak. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen, amen, amen. I am back again to talk to you as the Holy Spirit has led. And today's title is Christianity, Money and Greed. Christianity, Money and Greed. You know, this particular teaching is for individuals that are particularly in a position of authority, in a position of leadership, and even as a child of God. You see, most times as children of God, we start well, but most times a lot of people derail, and it's so disheartening to look at and observe things that are going on in the world right now. As a child of God and as a servant of God, he hurts me when people begin to generalize Christianity as, you know, they generalize Christianity. People don't take Christianity serious. They don't take Christians serious. Christians are not really taken serious. The first impression about Christians are like greed, are like, oh, they're driving the best jet, they're doing this, and their members are suffering, are like fake. You know, sometimes even the miracles, sometimes they are doubted. Anyways, already in the Bible, that the last days, most of those miracles are, some are fake. So, but we need to talk to each other as Christians. We need to understand, you know, yesterday I was watching a young boy that the Lord is using mightily, and then suddenly he deviated right in that program and started calling out people for money. If you bring this amount, I'll pray for you specially. Although he said the Lord did not say that. As a young man of God that God is using mightily, for him to follow that pattern, is either he has been told or he has watched people do it. My dear brothers and sisters, in the position of leadership, why would you differentiate? Why would there be class in the house of God? Why would you differentiate and say certain people come up for a specific amount of money, and if they give, then you'll give them a special prophecy or a special prayer? God didn't say that. I didn't see nowhere in the Bible where Jesus Christ said, if you bring this money, you stay on this side. If you bring that money, you stay on this side. And it's not written in the Bible. That is our flesh, and we need to stop it as servant of God. The Lord has told me to tell you to stop it. Otherwise, the cup of mercy is getting full. And when it gets full, you know what happens? The Lord turns his back. And that will not be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus. Why would you differentiate between people in the church? The church is for everybody. People have come to meet the Maker. They've come for different things. They've come for love. Some of them have come for their problems. So why would you now say, if you have this amount of money, whether you like it, I'm not speaking based on a personal experience. I'm speaking what the Holy Spirit wants us to know. Whether you like it or not, people come to church for problems. They come because they have problems, and they believe and know that when they come to see the Almighty, the Lord Almighty will answer them. So when you now come to church, somebody that is hungry, that probably does not even have transfer money to go back to where they're coming from, you now differentiate. What impression do you want them to have? And say, oh, the house of God is all about money. If I don't have money, they will not give me title. If I don't have money, I will not be recognized. If I don't have money, I will not get special anointing. This particular teaching, this particular topic is for, you know, I look at it like I'm a child of God. I just gave my life to Jesus Christ now. That is the way I put myself in that position, that I'm a born-again child of God. I just gave my life to Christ yesterday. And now I go to a church, and I have problem. I go to a church, and they tell me that you bring this money, I will get discouraged. You can't compare somebody that just gave their life to Jesus Christ yesterday with somebody that's been in the Lord for quite some time, because maturity comes in. That's how we grow from baby, from spiritual milk, then we begin to grow. So we need to stop it, children and servants of God, pastors, leaders, evangelists, whosoever you are, you need to stop it. If you are in a position of authority, if people want to sow into your ministry, they will sow willingly. God will send helpers to you willingly. You know, willingly is not something that is not something that you need to like cajole them and lie that the Holy Spirit said something when the Holy Spirit didn't say that. You cajole them to do something they don't want to do. Put them under duress. Make them make vows that they don't intend to make. But because of their problem and they believe that, oh, if this man of God or woman of God prays for me, the problem will be solved. People that have calling upon their life is, you know, there's everybody is a child of God. You are all anointed. But each person has their own calling and they have a special anointing. You know, they have a special thing with God. Moses was the only one that had, you know, after some time, he was the one that was seeing God face to face. So before Joshua, you know, it's the way God does this thing. As an individual, if I want to seek the face of God, I know what to do. If you connect to me, I know what to do, because I know what, you know, that's why you have to be careful that God called you. Because if God called you, you can go back to him and tell him, God, you called me, this is the situation, this, that, that, that. Unlike when you call yourself based on a certain circumstance, maybe because of unemployment or something. That's a different thing altogether. But we need to stop this attitude of coming, you go to church, they'll say, and then if you have $1, come to the front. If you have $2, you come to the front. If you have 1,000, you start dividing the children of God. For what? Why would you be differentiating children of God and say, this one, there shouldn't even be class in the church. Why should there be class in the church? We all came to church to worship the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. So there shouldn't be class in church. But the thing that is happening right now is there is class in the church. People are divided into, they know the ones that are poor, they know the people that don't pay tithes, then they leave them at the side. God is watching you. You need to stop it. And this is affecting leaders. It's affecting upcoming children of God, servants of God. It's affecting children of God that are just starting. People that God is just using. And you know, because you have mentors, you have people you look up to. So when you begin to look at them and say, oh, look at them, they drive the best car. Oh, how do they do it? You go and watch the way they do it. Then you begin to do it. That's exactly what happened to this young boy. He said it. He said, God did not say this. Then he started calling people. If you have this amount, come out. Immediately he did that. I turned it off. I became annoyed. Now, why would you do that? You see, these people, they came for prayer, they came for... If they want to sow into your life, my brother, my sister, nobody will feed you. It's God that will send help to you. If God, when the time comes for anybody to sow into your ministry, God will do it at his own time. And he will send somebody that you'll be shocked. I'm talking from my little experience, from the little... People that you don't even expect are the ones that will contact and sow into my life. So you need to understand, don't put money first in what God has called you for. The Bible says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and every other thing shall be added unto you. Every other thing. Not one thing, every other thing. The Lord will meet your needs. He knows what you want. He knows as a servant of God, because if a servant of God is poor, the anointing will speak nothing. Because people will assess you and say, if this one has a call upon their life, why is she frustrated? Why is he looking like this? God will not put you in that position. Never. No. That's not God. It will meet your need according to your riches. It will meet your need at that point. You will not beg. That's why if somebody asks me that, oh, if you need anything, ask me. I will not ask you. Because that's begging. But if the Holy Spirit employs it in your heart to sow into my life, you will sow. So you must respect the anointing over your head and the Almighty that called you. Stop this attitude of calling, offering for church. If you have a project, tell people there is a project. But please, servant of God, ministers of God, pastors, evangelists, reverend, whatever it is, deacon, deaconess, even normal child of God that you have put in a position, stop the attitude of calling people, separating them and prophesying into their life. For what? You say this one, you prophesy into this one, then you call another category. If you have a project, if you have a building project or you have something that the Lord has told you to do, tell the people you need this, tell them what you want. They will do it for you. The Holy Spirit will employ you. The Holy Spirit will provide for them. The Lord will provide for them. You don't need to talk too much. They will do it. Let us pray. Father Lord, I thank you. I give you glory. Thank you, everlasting Father, for speaking your word. Thank you, Lord, for all your children. Thank you, Lord, for even speaking to me, Lord. for everyone that is derailed, Father, please touch them to repent, Lord. And let this teaching not be used against me on the day of judgment. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen, amen, amen. I know that God himself is going to minister to all the men and women of God and people in leadership position, that you will stop that attitude. Please, please. Now back to our normal thing. Don't forget to join every Saturday, 9 p.m. UK time for a prayer session. Live on this channel is going to be live. This week's one is prayer for individuals that are trusting God for a job, for employment, for business ideas. That is what we're going to pray about. And as the Holy Spirit leads, you never know, we could deviate as the Holy Spirit leads. And then on Periscope, remember on Periscope, there's command in our morning, every morning, 4:30 a.m. to 5 a.m., Monday to Friday. Then on Saturday on YouTube channel, there is prayer session. And then on Facebook, follow us on Foundation on a Solid Rock Ministry. There are teachings there. We're going live on Facebook. There's even prayer session on Facebook too, on live. And I know that God will help you in the mighty name of Jesus. I remain your humble servant, Evangelist Miriam Molara Jakai. The Lord be with you. The Lord shine his face upon you. Everything you lay your hands upon, you will prosper in the mighty name of Jesus. Remember to like, subscribe, and share. Share, 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 share. If you have any prayer requests or anything, just send an email to me. And I'll reply you definitely by God's grace. See you soon. Daily as I live, often as I breathe, let my whole life be expression of your grace. I cry, Abba Father, Elohim be your name. Remember that. Live your life the way when Jesus Christ comes, you will not be ashamed. God bless you. Bye.